Good morning, Interweb. Let's Conlang. Today, let's create a number system for my language, OWA. Step 1, choose a base. So, quick recap. Most of us count using the decimal system, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Our decimal system is what's known as a base 10 positional number system. Base 10 means that 10 unique digits, 0 through to 9, are needed to represent any and all numbers. Positional notation is where numbers are separated into columns, each representing increasing powers of the base. So like 42, for example, doesn't get its own symbol. Instead, we construct it as 4 times 10 to the power of 1 plus 2 times 10 to the power of 0. But base 10 is not the only option here. Like base 2, aka binary, has 2 unique digits, 0 and 1, and each column represents increasing powers of 2. So 42 in binary would be 101010. Base 3 has 3 unique digits, 0, 1, and 2, and each column represents increasing powers of 3. 42 in base 3 is 1120. Same thing goes for all bases. Now, when it comes to choosing a base for a number system, it's worth noting that not all bases are created equally. The most practical bases, for humans, are those that aren't too high or too low and have lots of factors. So like base 720,720 would be a pain because we'd have to learn 720,720 unique numerals. Base 2 is no good because numbers get unwieldy really quick. And something like base 7 is no good because it only has two factors, 1 and 7. This makes even the most basic of division really cumbersome. So with all that in mind, I'm going to go with the one true base, base 12.
Whoa, base 12? Slow down there, Tolkien. Almost swept me up in an exciting new world of fantasy.
Oh, Jan Measley from Conlang Critic. What are you doing here?
I heard someone imply that decimal is the best numbering system, and I just sort of materialized. Dookie.
Well, I mean, it is.
Nah, sexsimal is where it's at.
Centenary or whatever, give me a break. 12 just makes more sense. You know, like counting eggs or donuts by the dozen.
But what about counting yams by the, group of 6 yams?
What? No, it has to be base 12. It's just the most elegant.
No, sexsimal is the most elegant.
Base 12.
6.
12.
6.
Okay, wait, I have an idea. How about we choose a different base? Mix things up a little, you know?
Yeah, okay. Since you've already decided that you want to use an elegant base, and since we obviously won't agree on what the most elegant base is, let's just do one of the runners-up. Oh, what about base 16?
Why base 16?
So, base 16, aka hex, is a solid base for a number of reasons. It's a favorite among computer scientists, because computers do things in binary, but while two digits is fine if all you have to work with is holes in a punch card or whatever, when you're representing numbers visually, you can do much better. Hex is a pretty natural way of making binary more usable, because 16 is exactly enough digits for you to be able to map each one to a unique sequence of 4 binary digits. That is, half a byte. Since a hex digit is equivalent to half a byte, they're sometimes called nibbles.
Aw, that's adorable.
Now, this ability to map sequences of bits to digits holds for every power of 2 base, but hex has one thing going for it that other power of 2 bases don't. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use my favorite method of analyzing the quality of different bases, looking at the expansions of the reciprocals of integers. Fun! Quick explanation of why I do this. In any base, an integer whose reciprocal has a simple expansion is one that base considers important, whereas an integer whose reciprocal has a complicated expansion is one that base considers less important.
Right, so 5 in our decimal system is pretty important, whereas 7 is not, because 1/5 is neater than 1/7, right?
Ding ding ding! Here's a big table, and I mean, just look at that. Honestly, I think this speaks for itself. Hex is clearly superior just looking at this.
Yeah, clearly.
Okay, let me explain. This table shows reciprocals of different integers in 5 different power of 2 bases. Since these bases are all powers of 2, they all essentially care about the same numbers. For all of these bases, the only terminating expansions are the powers of 2, for example. The interesting thing is when you look at how much each base cares about each number. Let's take every one of these ratios and see which base handles it best, which for our purposes can be demonstrated just by looking at how long the expansion is. Here are the winners.
Ah yeah, now it's clear. Base 16 definitely has its advantages. Let's stick with it.
Cool. Now that we have our base set, we can work on a numeral system. So we're doing regular positional notation, right?
Yeah, I don't want to overcomplicate things too much.
So no mixed radix or bijectivity or anything?
Let's stick to the basics for now.
Sure, let's just figure out how the 16 digits 0 through 15 should be written.
Okay, what do you think of this?
Oh, very nice.
My idea here is that the glyphs are grouped into eights. So don't think of it like this, think of it more like this. 9, for example, is a combination of 8 and 1. 10 is 8 and 2. 11 is 8 and 3. And so on.
So you got a sub-base of 8 going on. It's base 16 overall, but with a light hint of octal. Sort of like how French uses decimal with a 20-ish twist, calling 80 420s instead of 810s. You know, as neat as this is, it's a bit too, tidy.
Agreed, it needs to be more organic. Let's rotate the 9 glyph, make the 12 and 13 glyphs more organic, and add a line to the 8 glyph. That'll help obscure the sub-base a bit.
Better, but I think you could take it another step up. So, hear me out. Ever notice how in the Hindu Arabic numeral system, 2 and 7, 3 and 8, 4 and 9, and 5 and 6 look kinda similar? And that apart from 5 and 6, the like pairs differ by 5? It's a neat type of symmetry where, even if you're not conscious of it, it really helps make the digits look like they belong in the order they do, you know?
Oh yeah, and we could do something similar with our numeral system. What you think of these apples?
Oh heck yeah!
Most of the glyphs are now separated by 3. Not gonna lie, I kinda dig this.
So that's the way the numbers are written, but what about the words? I think this is where you have the most potential to do some creative stuff with how they can work. Like, you know how in English we have two basic sets of number words, the cardinals 1, 2, 3, and the ordinals 1st, 2nd, 3rd? Well, there's nothing really stopping you from doing more than that.
I'd like to go with 4 sets of number words.
Oh, I was thinking more like the 7 distinct sets of number words used in Japanese.
Well, I'd like to draw inspiration from Irish with its 4 sets of numbers. The disjunctive numbers, the non-human conjunctive numbers, the human conjunctive numbers, and the ordinals.
Keeping it local, yeah, that works too.
Cool, so riffing off this, how about we go with disjunctive numbers, inanimate conjunctive numbers, animate conjunctive numbers, and the ordinals.
Sounds good to me.
Let's have the basic disjunctive numbers between 0 and 16 be nos, kia, roa, ngolo, sa, lila, oro, hingo, ha, oma, yara, koyo, ki, ha'a, la'i, roro, min.
Now hold on, are those grouped into sets of 4? You sure do like your subbases, huh?
Yeah, I was imagining 4-fingered and 4-toed creatures counting on their fingers and toes, so 4 bundles of 4. Those words may even be the literal names of their appendages. Who knows?
Nice. Also, what's that E particle?
So when counting with these numbers, you have to add the E particle. Like how you might say a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4. Ikia, iroa, ingolo, isa. In addition to counting, disjunctive numbers are used for maths, time telling, and declarative numbers.
Neat. What about the inanimate numbers?
So the inanimate conjunctive numbers are used to count, well, inanimate objects. The E particle is dropped here. Nos, kia, ta, molo, si, lila, oro, hingo, ha, oma, yara, koyo, ki, ha'a, la'i, roro, min.
Plus, a couple words are different. Roa becomes ta, sa becomes si.
Yup, I figured low numbers get used more often and thus are more susceptible to mutation. Also, Irish does a very similar thing. Si lama, 6 bucks.
The animate numbers?
These are used to count animate objects and for the most part get the pn suffix. Nos, kia ahuan, onongari, ngolopen, sipen, lilapen, oropen, hingopen, hapen, omapen, yarapen, koyopen, kipen, haapen, laipen, roropen, meepen.
What the heck is with 1 and 2? Where'd you pull those from?
So, kia hini ahuan means one woman, but literally one woman, alone, only, just, etc. And onongari hini means two women, literally a couple, a pair, or a twosome of women. The idea being that inanimate nouns get counted like 1, 2, 3, but animate nouns get counted with more animate words, like alone, couple, twosome, if that makes sense.
Okay, so like a singular and dual sort of thing. I'm down. But do you have any specific reason to stop at dual? I think the trial deserves more love. Why not a threesome of goats?
Mainly Irish, but let's stick in a trial form just for the crack. Ngawalo hua.
Cool. And finally, the ordinals. What messiness do you have planned here?
Actually, it's pretty clean here. Kia remains unchanged, and all the rest get the im suffix. Kia, tam, molom, sim, lilam, orom, hingom, ham, omam, yaram, koyom, kim, ha'am, la'im, rorom, mim.
So the third goat would be something like ngolom hoa, am I right?
Spot on. Now after 16, all multiples of 16 get the as suffix, namely roas, ngolas, sas, lilas, oras, hingas, has, omas, yaras, koyas, kas, ha'as, la'as, and roas. 256 is kiar. This holds across the board. Now, in between these are two different patterns, one for the teens and one for all numbers less than 256.
Oh, so literally just what English does?
Exactly.
Sounds boring, but okay.
What can I say? I like my Conlangs nice and familiar. So the teen analogues work like a 1 and 16, a 2 and 16, a 3 and 16, all the way up to a 15 and 16. Ikiamlin, Iroamlin, Ingolomlin, Iroromlin. Similar shtick across the other systems.
Lol, mlin. That's really fun to say. Mlin.
And numbers greater than 32 will pattern like multiple of 16 of 1, multiple of 16 of 2, multiple of 16 of 3, etc.
So 33 would be roasikya, 49 would be molasikya, 65 would be sasikya, and so on.
Exactly.
Cool. Now, we can and should keep going, but I think 256 is a decent stopping point. I'm happy with what we got so far.
Me too. Hey, don't you have some Conlangs to critique or something?
Ah, right. Critiquing Conlangs. That's what I was doing before I manifested here. Definitely not just playing Rhythm Heaven.
Yeah, definitely not. Anyways, Jan Measley, thank you for popping over.
Thanks for having me. Till next time, Measley out.
Good morning, Interweb. If you like Conlangs like Tokipona, Vorquel, Lojban, Ithquil, Esperanto, Napvi, Klingon, Dothraki, etc., you gotta go check out Conlang Critic. Links in all the usual places. Massive thanks to Jan Measley of Conlang Critic for helping with this video. I think it turned out pretty cool. Massive thanks to you for watching, and a massive thanks go out to all the wonderful folks over on Patreon who helped make Artifexian a possibility, including Isaac Silbert, Andrew Chehayl, Robin Hilton, World Anvil, Ripta Pasay, John Hooyer, Alexander Roper, and A. E. Stephenson. Until next time, Edgar out.